Scorpio. The oracle card for you is the butterfly ferrets, and what it says is that you've gone through a great process of transformation. There's been a lot that you have seen, and this recent time has been a time of great pain leading to growth. You will be protected by the universe when you are at your most vulnerable, and you are going to be loved and cherished by the universe. So, you are safe and you have the space to grow. The rune that you've drawn is Yera, and what this says is that you are at a time of a harvest. With everything that you've been through, now is the time for you to actually start reaping the benefits. So you are ready to take wings and you are ready to fly. And while you are getting ready to do that, the universe is going to do its utmost best to kind of protect you. Now what we're going to do is we're going to be talking about Mercury and how the planet retrograding is going to affect you in 2021. Retrograding planets are planets that appear to be going backwards in the sky, and they always have a lot to teach us. In this case, they are there in your home sector in Jan. So here you are. You need to reevaluate your situation and take a break and have a look at things from a different perspective. You need to work on issues that you feel need your attention. Remember, this is all about teamwork, and working with family and people you love are things that can only be done collaboratively. You cannot be the only one working, or they are the only ones working, and you need to listen as well as speak your mind. And coming to that is this. So you are being warned, so as to speak, to listen to others. Watch your words. You don't need to win any fights or arguments for the sake of winning. And also, do not in anger say anything that can be taken out of context and be used against you. In this time, and by sorting out things, you're going to be building a legacy that will be far-reaching, that will have far more reaching consequences than you think, because Saturn is in the same area in your chart right now. So that explains the need to kind of shift perspective, look at things, work collaboratively, and then carry on till you have a stability and you have a legacy that you can begin to pass on. In June, Mercury, the quicksilver planet, decides to grace your house of intimacy and brings back people from the past. In the intimacy sector, old flames and old friends will return from the past. This will throw light onto your present relationships, mostly the dissatisfaction that you have brewing within them. The focus is going to be on what is not working out as opposed to what is. But all of this dissatisfaction is going to give you space for growth. You will decide what you want to carry forward and what baggage you want to leave behind, which is kind of very healthy because it's going to lead to growth and to deciding as to whom you want to commit to and how much. In October, Mercury decides to take one more walk, this time activating areas of your subconscious. You are forced to go within your mind and face your fears. There can be confusion, but the benefit is bringing back a creative streak and really getting on with your life. This time, Mars is a planet which will also drive and push you on to explore your subconscious. After you face your psyche, it is a necessary part of your step of your journey to give yourself a certain amount of rest and relaxation. You need to realize that everything that you have pulled out from your mental landscape in terms of what your fears are, what's bothering you, what is your deepest level of creativity, you do not need to deal with everything in one go. You can take it as one battle at a time. You move on to seeing what it is that you really need to have fulfillment. So even in your mental landscape, you're going to be using this time to drop a lot of baggage and then move on, which definitely is going to be healthy in the long run. Then we move on to Mars. This aggressive go-getter enters your relationship sector where it meets Uranus. In January, Mars will push you to mingle with others and it will stay in this sector till April. So you have this whole period of friendships and getting on to meeting people, and there's going to be a certain amount of letting go of those things that are not working for you anymore. So again, this year you see a lot of clearing of things, of baggage, of relationships that don't work, of ideas that don't work anymore. Yeah? And you're going to be busy having a party and there's going to be an overflow of love in your life, more or less. So it's going to be a good time for you overall. This year numerologically is a 5 year, which means that a lot of your personal beliefs, systems that you rely on for your spirituality and how you perceive the world emotionally is going to be affected. For you, Scorpio, there's going to be a need for a deeper spiritual emotional connection in your life, especially the intimate ones. And again, you're also going to be going through this whole soul searching that the 5 year is known for. In June, Mars will enter your career and income section. You're going to be driven to achieve your goals and succeed at them. You can manifest anything you set your heart on. So plan, decide upon your vision, and decide how you want to carry on. If you're in a job that you enjoy, then the work in itself is going to bring you a lot of joy and you'll be completely enveloped in that whole creative process of working, being a complete workaholic. And the good part is that there is achievement, recognition and success that is coming down this line. In May, there's going to be a lunar eclipse as well that is going to help you cut away everything that doesn't serve you and that doesn't work with your philosophy. Now in December, Mars teams up with Uranus in your financial house to give you the drive to make money in the most unconventional ways. So with Uranus comes in newness. It is about following your heart. It is about doing things that other people might find foolish, but really, really marching to the beat of your own inner drummer. You're going to be enjoying yourself and creating in a very unconventional way. So you might do things that are not traditionally what is the norm. You might set up a new venture. And this kind of falls in line with the pandemic. I think there's been so much growth in so many areas for people who can adapt and move on. You will also have new projects, energies and drive, and there is going to be a lot of internal push coming your way to do things. Make sure you use it. Jupiter is in your home sector this year. While Jupiter promotes expansion, this year it shares a space with Saturn, which sets up structures and uses discipline as its mainstay. So while Saturn contracts and Jupiter expands, it is going to be an interesting year. So whatever you do this year, Jupiter is going to make sure that the effect of it is pushed in for decades to come. This year you will take on more responsibility. Either you take it on or it's going to be thrust upon you. There's going to be more limitations and restrictions. So there's going to be this constant feeling about things being pushed on you, of not being in control of yourself and of being completely restricted. But the good part is, dear Scorpio, that you're going to be able to find balance and you're going to be able to merge both of those opposing aspects and still forge your way ahead. Neptune rules your love life all year round, and this dreamy planet will allow you to stay open to love and experiences. So there's going to be, your cup is going to run over, there's going to be a feeling of a lot of love, you will be operating from that. And there's this whole needing to love yourself, and at the same time, as I said before with other planets, everything that's unnecessary in your life, things that are not essential, people that are not, that have given you the experience, or people that you're not in sync with, is now going to move on. As far as Pluto is concerned, that is going to be in the area of your intellectual sector in your chart. And what Pluto does is, it's going to bring about transformation on the deep level. So it's going to help you transform the way you plan, your thought processes. This is a year where you're going to let go of your limiting beliefs and journey into your thoughts. And it's going to be a very, very rewarding year, so as to speak. I wish you all the best for you, dear Scorpio. Have a lovely 2021.